Today we'll continue with discussing methods for comparing classifiers. In that, today we'll discuss comparing the performance of two models and performance of two classifiers. Comparing the performance of two models. So again, consider a pair of models, that is M1 and M2, that are evaluated on two independent test sets, D1 and D2. M1 will be evaluated on D1. And M2 will be evaluated on D2. Let N1 denote the number of records in D1 and N2 denote the number of records in D2. N1 number of records in D1 and N2 is the number of records in D2. In addition, suppose the error rate for M1 on D1 is E1 and the error rate for M2 on D2 is E2. So consider this also. So consider E1 is the error rate for M1 on the data D1. E1 is the error rate for M1. Similarly, E2 is the error rate for M2. Our goal is to test whether the observed difference between E1 and E2 is statistically significant. Okay, our goal is to test whether the observed difference. Now, we have to check the difference between E1 and E2 and check whether it is statistically significant. Assuming that N1 and N2 are sufficiently large, the error rates E1 and E2 can be approximated using normal distributions. So here E1 and E2 are approximated using normal distributions because we are considering N1 and N2 are large data set. If the observed difference in the error rate is denoted as D, which is equal to E1 minus E2, then D is also normally distributed with mean D1. Because we are considering E1 and D2 are approximated using the normal distribution. That's why D, that is difference between this E1 and D2, is also normally distributed with mean D1, its true difference and variance sigma D square. The variance of D can be computed as follows. Sigma D square, which is approximately equal to sigma D cap square, which is equal to E1 into 1 minus E1 divided by N1 plus E2 into 1 minus E2 divided by N2, where this E1 into 1 minus E1 divided by N1 and E2 into 1 minus E2 divided by N2, that is these two terms are the variance of the error rates. Okay, these two terms are variance of the error rates. First term is the variance of E1 and second term is the variance of E2. Finally, at the 1 minus alpha percentage confidence level, it can be shown that the confidence interval for the true difference DT is given by the following equation. So DT is equal to D plus or minus Z alpha by 2. Sigma D cap. Okay. This is the 1 minus alpha percentage confidence level. At the 1 minus alpha percentage confidence level, we are checking the true difference. Okay. We are checking the true difference, that is DT. That is by this equation. DT is equal to D plus or minus Z alpha by 2. This is Z alpha by 2. It's a confidence level. Okay, sigma D cap. Consider this example. Consider the problem that is which we have discussed in the previous class. That is, model MA has an error rate of E1 is equal to 0.15 when applied to N1 is equal to 30 records. Well, model MB has an error rate of E2 which is equal to 0.25 when applied to N2 which is equal to 5000 records. So MA and MB are two models. Okay, MA and MB are two models with the error rate E1 is equal to 0.15 and E2 is equal to 0.25 respectively for each model. And here MA is applied on only 30 records and MB is applied on 5000 records. The observed difference in their error rate is, so now we can calculate D, which is equal to E1 minus E2. Okay, D is equal to E1 is 0.15 minus 0.25 25, it is in between two parallel lines. That means we are getting the absolute value of this. We are not considering the negative sign here. You will get minus 0.1, right? So we are ignoring the negative sign here. So it is absolute value of this difference, which is equal to 0.1. 0.15 minus 0.25, you'll get minus 0.1, right? So ignore that. So it will be 0.1. This is the absolute value of the difference. In this example, we are performing a two-sided test to check whether DT is equal to 0 or DT not equal to 0. Okay, whether DT is equal to 0. Here, we should get DT is equal to 0. Then we can prove that it's a null hypothesis. It matches with the null hypothesis. That is, it doesn't have any much difference between these two. Okay. And here we have to check whether DT is equal to 0 or DT not equal to 0. Okay. If DT is equal to 0, then it is statistically significant. If DT not equal to 0, it is not significant. Okay. The estimated variance of the observed difference in error rates can be computed as follows. So we are going to compute the estimated variance. Okay. So which is equal to sigma d square, which is approximately equal to sigma d square cap, which is equal to e1 into 1 minus e1 divided by n1 plus e2 into 1 minus e2 divided by n2. That is, first term is variance of e1, second term is variance of e2. So here observed difference, which is equal to, so apply the values here. We know the value of e1, 0.15 into 1 minus 0.15 divided by number of records is equal to 30. That is n1, plus e2 is 0.25 into 1 minus 0.25 divided by n2 is 5000 records. So 5000, which we get it as 0.0043. Or here this is sigma d cap square. Right, sigma d cap square 0.0043. So sigma d cap, that is a square root of this value, that is 0.0043, is equal to 0.0655. Inserting this value into the equation 4.15, this is 4.15, that is a true difference. We are going to obtain the true difference at the confidence level 95% now, because they have given that in the question, right? At 95%, we have to, if we calculate, then DT is equal to D plus or minus Z alpha by 2, which is 95%, then sigma D cap. So apply the values here. At 95% confidence level, in the last class, we were discussing with one table. Okay. In that table, for 95% confidence level, we get Z alpha by 2 value as 1.96. Same value is applied here. Okay. Using that table, the content for 95%, Z alpha by 2 is equal to 1.96. That is applied here. So difference which we have got is 0.1, right? That is E1 minus E2. We got D, that is 0.1 plus or minus. This is the value of Z alpha by 2, that is 1.96, into, this is sigma d cap, 0.0655. So which is equal to 0.1 plus or minus 0.128. You can notice here whether you add it or whether you subtract it. 0.1 plus 0.128, you'll get 0.228. If you subtract it, you'll get 0.028, but it is not equal to 0. You can notice that value. Whether you add it or subtract it, it is not equal to 0. As the interval spans the value 0, we can conclude that the observed difference is not statistically significant at a 95% confidence level. Okay, it is not significant. So at what confidence level can we reject the hypothesis that DT is equal to 0? Okay, when we can reject this hypothesis, DT is equal to 0. To do this, we need to determine the value of Z alpha by 2 such that the confidence interval for D1 does not span the value 0. Okay, that is, we can reverse the preceding computation what we have done just now and look for the value of Z alpha by 2 such that D is greater than z alpha by 2 multiplied with sigma d cap. Replacing the values of d and sigma d cap gives z alpha by 2 less than 7.525. This value first occurs when 1 minus alpha is less than or equal to 0.936. Okay, we have seen for 95%, this is for 0.936. When we have the value of 1 minus alpha less than or equal to 0.936 for two-sided test. The result suggests that the null hypothesis can be rejected at confidence level of 93.6% or lower. Okay, so value that we can reject, is at 93.6%. That is 1 minus alpha is less than or equal to 0.936. So this null hypothesis can be rejected at confidence level 93.6% or lower. So next one is comparing the performance of two classifiers. Suppose we want to compare the performance of two classifiers using the K-fold cross-validation approach. K-fold means here we are going to divide the input data into K number of samples, okay, or K subsets. And on each subset, we are going to apply the classifier and we are going to compare how it works, okay. So initially the data set D is divided into K equal sized partitions. We then apply each classifier to construct a model from K minus one of the partitions and test it on the remaining partition. Okay, so we have K minus one partition, K number of partitions, and we are going to construct a model. That is, we are going to train the model using K minus one number of partitions and test it on the remaining partition, that is kth partition. This step is repeated k times. Okay, once the model is constructed with all the data, it will be tested. Okay, which with each subset, it will be tested. That's why it is repeated k number of times. Each time using a different partition as the test. Okay, it will be constructed using k minus one number of partitions. Then it will be tested with k number of partitions. Okay, I hope you're getting. Then consider, let Mij denote the model induced by classification technique Li during the jth iteration. Iteration is, that is, we have k number of test sets here, or k number of data sets we have on the jth iteration on some test set. Among k, we are taking the jth iteration, okay, where j is less than k here, okay, some jth iteration we are considering. So Mij is the model used for that. Consider Mij is the model used for that, and we are using the classification technique Li. So consider we are comparing two classification technique here. One is Li, okay. So Mij is the model. Mij is the model which is constructed using the classification technique Li during the jth iteration, or using jth subset, I can say. Note that each pair of models, M1i and M2i, are tested on the same partition J. So two models we are going to test here, because we are trying to compare two classifier. You can notice that that value i is same, M1i and M2i, or you can consider M1j and M2j are tested on the same partition J. Okay, are tested on the same partition J. Let E1i and E2i, their respective error rates. Consider these two are the error rates. That is, E1i is the error rate for M1i and E2i is the error rate for M2i. The difference between their error rates during the jth fold can be written as dj is equal to E1j minus E2j. So find the difference. Okay, find the difference between these two error rates. If k is sufficiently large, then dj is normally distributed with the mean dt. Dt is the true difference. Dt is the true difference cv. which is the true difference in their error rates, and variance sigma CV. Okay, variance sigma CV. Unlike the previous approach, the overall variance in the observed differences is estimated using the following formula. That is sigma d CV square, sigma d CV cap square, which is equal to summation j is equal to 1 to k dj minus d dash whole square divided by k into k minus 1, where this d bar is the average difference. Okay, this is the average difference among all the differences which we have calculated on each data set. Okay, get the test data set, apply the model on test data sets, and whatever the differences we get, okay, get the average of the differences. Okay, get the average of the differences, that is d bar. For this approach, we need to use a t distribution to compute the confidence interval for DTCV. This is we have in a table. I'll show you that table, that is t distribution table. So DTCV is equal to d bar plus or minus t 1 minus alpha comma k minus 1. This is the t distribution value. Okay, this is the t distribution value at 1 minus alpha and k minus 1. Okay, sigma d cap, sigma d CV cap. The coefficient t 1 minus alpha k minus 1 is obtained from the probability table with two input parameters. That is, one is 1 minus alpha, which is confidence level, and another one is degree of freedom. That is number of degrees of freedom, that is k minus 1. K minus 1 is the number of degrees of freedom. This is shown in the table. Okay, this is the table for that. So these are the k minus 1 value. That is, when you have two data sets, it will be, you can consider one. So 2 minus 1, 1. When you have three data sets, 3 minus 1, 2. Then when you have five data sets, 5 minus 1, 4. When you have 30 data sets, so 30 minus 29. 30 minus 1, which is equal to 29. Okay. These are the 1 minus alpha value, that is 0.99, 0.98, 0.95, 0.9 and 0.8. That is 99%, 98%, 95%, 90% and 80%. Okay. So consider this example. Suppose the estimated difference in the accuracy of models generated by two classification techniques has a mean equal to 0.05. Okay. Mean value, that is average value, D slash, it is 0.05, and a standard deviation equal to 0.002, that is sigma d cap. Standard deviation is equal to 0.002. If the accuracy is estimated using a 30-fold cross validation, 30-fold means k value is 30 here. Okay, 34 means 30 means 30-fold means k value is equal to 30. That is data set, whatever we have, that will be divided into 30 subsets. Okay, then at a 95% confidence level, this is the 1 minus alpha value, 95% confidence level, the true accuracy difference is, you can notice that we'll apply the values in this. So DTCV, that is the true difference, is equal to D slash, this value is given, that is 0.05, plus or minus this value of t at 1 minus alpha and k minus 1, we have to see from your table. And here sigma d cap CV, which is equal to the standard deviation we have, that is 0.002. So apply the values here. So dt CV 0.05 plus or minus 2.04 into 0.002. So from where we have got this 2.04, I'll show you that. So we have 34, that is k value is 30, and we have 95% confidence interval, right? We have 95% confidence interval, that this is the 1 minus alpha, and it is 30-fold. 30-fold is k is equal to 30, k minus 1, which is equal to 29. So here 2.04, okay? At k minus 1, 24, this is the value we have, and at 0.05, that is at 95% confidence level, we have this value 2.04. Okay, apply this value. So we'll get the value, since the confidence interval does not span the value 0. This value will not be equal to 0, right? 0.05 plus or minus 2.04 into 0.002. You can calculate this value. Okay, if we, I'll tell you the value. What is the value for this? So we have 0.05. If I put plus 2.04 into 0.002, if I put plus, you'll get 0.05408. Okay, 0.05 will get. Okay, when we put plus. If we put minus, we'll get 0.04. So we can notice that this interval does not span the value 0. It is not spanning the value 0. So the observed difference between the technique is statistically significant. Since it is not equal to 0, it is statistically significant. If it is equal to 0, it is not statistically significant. Okay, if you have any doubts, you can ask me.